think hydro is uniquely posed to solve some of the technical challenges with renewable energy. And there's also tremendous opportunity for innovation. The major growth in hydro happened many, many years ago. So there's a tremendous opportunity to bring new technology to hydro.
We were at a moment in time that we acquired the facility and we had to do a full upgrade. We actually have a partnership with General Electric, and that partnership has a lot of different venues and activities that it pursues. But one of them was the pursuit to install the first of a kind GE aerating turbine.
The nice thing about our design is that we basically keep a standard turbine design for the regular runner blade. And the only thing we really have to compromise on, and it's not even much of a compromise, is we have to make sure there's enough space in the thickness of the runner blade itself to have an air channel that's going to take the air from the air inlets down to our interblade profiles. And we wanted to look at the factors that make dissolved oxygen transfer work better. And what it really comes down to is small bubbles that are well distributed in the water, and an additional benefit of having naturally occurring low pressure zones that draw the air into the turbine without needing any compressors.
Some of the initial work was started in 2012. It was with the St. Anthony Falls Laboratory at the University of Minnesota. We took that information, the results that we obtained with SAFL, and integrated that into our design to come up with the interblade profile to maximize the aeration potential of the turbines. The turbine aeration system on its own works when the turbine is aerated.
HYROC is a peaking facility, meaning that the turbines are on only a portion of the day, and there's a lot of the day when the turbines aren't on, and we need to make sure we improve aeration during that period. And the linear aerating valve does that in a far simpler and cheaper method than the traditional technology did.
When we bought the Yadkin project, of which HYROC is the furthest upriver, we had a requirement to improve the water quality of the Yadkin River under the new license that got issued. So one of the things we had to do was implement new technologies in order to do that.
What we have here is a unique partnership between Cube Hydro, the owner-operator, who sort of defines the need of having to comply with requirements, the turbine manufacturer, in this case, General Electric, who has devised a unique turbine system that actually aerates the water and adds oxygen to the water, and the Department of Energy, specifically the Pacific Northwest National Laboratory, who has developed a monitoring system to collect data on dissolved oxygen, both upstream here in the forebay and downstream of the project, and then eventually tying it directly to project operations so we can be more predictive about the amount of dissolved oxygen coming into the project, the amount of dissolved oxygen coming out of the project, and so the operations of the turbine can be optimized to both comply with environmental requirements and optimize electric generation.
We really have always felt that hydropower has been an incredible technology and asset for the nation. The reality is that the generation of today looks very different than the generation of yesterday. And when we look at the requirements into the future, if it's flexibility, if it's clean energy, if it's carbon-free energy, whatever it may be, hydropower is uniquely squarely in the middle of all those topics. So we think that hydro can not only continue to provide clean, affordable electrons for decades to come, but it could be a technology that can facilitate the integration of our energy transformation. And that's exciting.